In this video, we're going to talk about a project initiated by one of the Rotary Clubs in Cochin, Rotary Club of Cochin, Cosmos. This project is titled Hug a Tree and is aimed at creating an awareness regarding the importance of protecting the trees around us. Today we have with us Rotarian Venkatesh, the president of the club, talking to Rotarian Saju on what this project is all about and the way forward. Friends, this is Only Green, and Only Green is all about making our world a greener place. And we're sure that this project is the right direction to make the world greener. The team Only Green salutes Rotary Cochin Cosmos for this wonderful initiative, and we wish them all the very best. Friends, please do subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button so that you don't miss any updates. Over to you, Saju and Vinky.
Hi, Saju, Rotary Cochin Cosmos in the remember, and we are actually thinking about a project. So we thought that we'll come and live and we'll explain this project for the benefit of everybody, so that you will be able to know that what is that we are thinking about this project, how you can participate in it. Let me introduce our president, Mr. Venkatesh.
Hello.
Venkatesh is heading Rotary Cochin Cosmos this year. So I will be inviting president to speak about this project in a little bit, and wherever the time allows, I will intervene. I will ask some questions for the benefit of you. So Venki, can you explain me how this project has emerged and what is this all about?
Thank you. So this year, the Rotary District of 3201 has three priorities. It's called YES, Y-E-S, Youth, Environment and Shelter. And like every other club, and every other Rotary in the district, we have been doing a lot of projects in the youth sector, working with children and everything. And on the shelter side of things, we have been working on building houses and everything. So when it comes to the environment, what I found was that a lot of clubs, a lot of people were interested in planting trees, and they would find space and they would plant trees. But in a lot of these cases, we will plant some trees and maybe take care of it for a little while, but after that people actually forget about it and they move on, and a lot of these trees don't get the enough care and adequate attention, so they will die away in the course of time. So one thing that came to our attention was how can we save the trees that are already there, because deforestation is a big issue that the world is facing right now. So how do we create some awareness in people about saving the trees, and what can we do to preserve what is existing? So that is how the whole idea of saving the trees came up. And then one of the experiences that we had a couple of years ago, when we went to a forest in Attapally, and then one naturalist took us to a tour, and then we all were given an opportunity to hug the tree and then experience what it was like. So we kind of merged the two and we created this project called Cosmos Hug a Tree. It is basically a campaign asking people to find the tree that's close to them, hug it for a minute, and then share the experience, like what do they feel when they hug the tree. So,
Okay, Cosmos Hug a Tree, tagline is very, very catchy. Why Cosmos Hug a Tree? Why that project is named as Cosmos Hug a Tree? And what is that you are expecting out of it? Yes, I could understand that. Go hug a tree and after that create a video and post it in the social media.
Yeah.
How does it help for this entire thing?
Okay. So, the Cosmos Hug a Tree project, like I said, is inviting people to hug a tree and then post what they feel about in that. But when we hug the person, right? When we hug the person, or when we go meet people and we talk to them. When we hug them, we get a good vibe from them, right? I mean, we exchange energies. We get that positive vibe from people. And in the same manner, when you hug the tree, you find a relationship. You somehow connect with the tree. And I'm sure the trees also feeling the same, if you believe that the trees are also living beings. So the whole idea of the project, like I said, is a campaign, is to create awareness. And for people to start taking notice. So, I mean, we have been walking here in all these places, running and everything, but we may not have noticed many trees that are around us, right? But when you start hugging trees, even now, like in the last couple of days when I start, now you start taking notice of the trees, you know. And then the trees also, like, people, they may get sick or something like that. So you can take care of the trees. You can, you know, bring them back to health instead of cutting down the trees. That's also possible. But people have to think like that. It's very easy for us to say that, oh, this tree is not giving us anything. That, like, any tree, even if it doesn't give any fruit or anything, that it's at least giving shade.
Mm.
So trees always give things to us. You know, the shade, there is wood, and there are a lot of birds that form nests in the trees. So a tree is a big ecosystem. It has a lot of things that value. So we just thought that this project will bring attention to the trees. People will start noticing the trees. And if we can spread this message, I mean, this is not restricted to Kochi or Rotary District or anything like that. This can be a global thing. And if people start feeling, you know, connection to the trees, and they start, you know, making an awareness of the trees around them, when they plan projects, when they plan a city project or when they plan a project, they will start thinking about it. They will start putting more attention to that. How can I make a project without clearing the trees? You know, we are not saying that we should not build buildings or anything, but how can we preserve the trees and still live with them, right? I mean, it's all about coexistence, right? It's not only that human beings need to exist in this planet. We need to exist with the trees, with the animals, everything. So how can we create meaningful projects? And when we build cities around us, how do we do that? By allowing the trees to stay, allowing them to live, and then, you know, create something alongside that. It's not about destroying them and then building something on top of that. So that's the objective. So over a period of time, I mean, I'm sure that it don't happen overnight, but over a period of time, if we take 3 months or 6 months, that's fine. But over a period of time, I'm sure that this will create a value for people, and it will create a movement where people connect to the trees, and they also feel the need to preserve the trees.
Absolutely right, Winky. After launching this project, I was also part of it, by the way. When I started creating some videos for that, so yesterday I tried moving in this Cochin Panambali area, and I tried hugging a tree. And almost around 60 seconds I was hugging this tree, and I could see that a relationship is getting established with the tree.
Correct.
Now in my lifetime I cannot forget that tree.
Yes.
Because I feel like adopting that tree. The tree has become my family member.
Yes.
Like my Kashyap or Ganga. Now this tree is also part of mine. Second thing, like you said, what I noticed is that trees can't do any harm to anybody. Correct. It can only love people. It can only love people, it can only give shelter or whatever you said, that only a tree can do it. Very good, okay. Venki, I also heard that, okay, trees are something like our ancestors.
Yeah, you can believe, some people do believe in that. Like, you know, they see that, you know, when people, I mean, like every other, you know, living being that takes one birth. So birth after birth, I mean, it is believed that the soul will get a rebirth as some other thing, right? You can be born as an animal, you can be born as a... So it can, the same way, you can also be born as a tree. And in all our births, knowingly or unknowingly, like you said, we may do some harmful things to others or something like that. So that is why we get another birth. Because we need to make sure that we have one birth which is completely harmless. And then only you get the moksha of having no birth. So by using that concept, a tree could be the last birth of a soul. And the tree is born, and then after that, you know, you don't get the rebirth, because the tree, like you said before, does not do any harm to anybody. It always does good things. So in that case, it's probably the noblest soul that is there. So by going by that concept, it could be one of our ancestors' soul that get reborn as a tree. Yeah, that's the concept that some people believe in. That is.
You mean to say that yesterday I hugged that tree? So when I was looking around, I could see this tree calling me. I don't know why I selected that tree. Can be one of my ancestors.
Yeah, it could be.
We
yeah.
can say that. Okay, great, great thought, Vicky. So what is way forward if I wanted to participate, and what is the goal you have taken? How you wanted to see that? How I can participate as an individual?
Yeah, so how we can participate as an individual, like I said, this is probably the phase one of our project. And in the phase one of our project, we are asking people to hug a tree, and record themselves on video and share their experience of hugging a tree, and also trying to, you know, send a message to others, inspiring them to do the same. That's kind of phase one. But once we, you know, probably inspire, I don't know, we touch about, you know, 10,000 people doing these things, we can then take it to the next level of, you know, what are the things that we can do to, you know, go and preserve trees that are existing in places. And we can start movement. I think one of the more important things is also to get the younger generation to understand the value of trees, right? So, you know, we can run campaigns in schools, there could be competitions, essay and speech competitions, and all those things. And also children, I think if the children also wanted them also to participate in it in large numbers, hug a tree and then, see what they get out of that. So, basically we are just, like I said, we are starting a movement and we hope that it will catch on. And what next? We can plan it a little bit, but at the same time, a movement like this usually, gets a shape of its own after, we get larger participation across the globe. When people start participating in it, it will take a life of its own. It will take shape, and I hope that we will get celebrities to participate in it, so their message could be it may go farther, it may reach more people than what we are trying to do. And it will finally reach the authorities who are in power when they do the city planning and all the things. That's one of the major goals, is to, even right now we are living in urban spaces where we need open space, where we need trees, right? So that people can come and enjoy that nature. So I hope that, this movement will inspire a lot of that happening in the near future. That's our plan.
Great talk. Friends, let me speak about, he's a very inspiring person, and I'm sure that it's been communicated really well. As the goal says that by March 31st, we have to inspire around 10,000 people around the world. Around the world, so that maybe 10,000 or plus trees can be adopted by,
correct,
and we can save it. A small movement which can change the lives of the people or a quality of the life in the earth. The question arises that how I can participate it in a very simpler way. What is that you have to do? If you want to participate in Cosmos Hug a Tree project, what is that you have to do? I'm sure that that question will be striking in your mind. Friends, what you have to do? You have to go and look around. Is one tree calling you? Go and stand nearby that tree. Look at that tree. Feel that tree. And hug that tree. We are launching it on February 14th, Valentine's Day 2021. Hug that tree for 1 minute or 2 minutes or 3 minutes, how much ever you like. Let me promise you that once you hug it, it will be very difficult to get detached from that tree. Once you move out of it, okay, this entire thing, allow somebody to take a video and share that experience with us. How did you feel? What did you feel when you hugged that tree? This is what we are looking forward. And upload that video in our Facebook page. We have a WhatsApp number. In the poster, you can see that. You can upload in that or in our YouTube page. Wherever it is possible, you upload it and inspire the people around the world. Point number one, open a camera, put it in video mode, hug a tree, shoot it, and explain your messages, your experiences on that, upload in the Facebook page. This is the first step of it for Cosmos Hug a Tree to become a part of it. All the best wishes, looking forward for 10,000 people, Vengi.
Yeah.
I'm sure that together we will be able to do that. And I think there is a beautiful tree standing here.
Small tree.
I think we need to really hug it. And this is a small plant. Actually, it is not a tree.
It's not become a tree yet.
Yeah. So I'm sure that when we become very old, maybe by 70 or 80 years, this will be a big tree where we will come and again stand under this tree and talk about this project.
Thank you.
And have a great day. Please participate in this project, Cosmos Hug a Tree.
Don't forget to hug a tree.
Thank you.